Welcome back to Let's Play Torment, Tides of Numenera. I'm the RPG Chick. We have been through the Oasis Fathom, the Crefton Fathom, the Village Fathom, the Endless Battle Fathom, and now here in the First Fathom. I cannot fathom how many more fathoms we will get to. But anyway, we have another portal going to somewhere, which I can't see. Normally you'd be able to see, you know, the symbol of like a door, right? This scene transition, but they've either removed it so we can't know where we're going, or it's underneath this point of interest. But in any case, just to recap, right, the resonance chamber has trapped me and all the other castoffs in the labyrinth. The ghostly woman says the true resonance is in the deepest part of my mind. I have to get there before the specter if I want to decide the fate of the castoffs. The specter is on his way to the resonance. I have to get there first to stop him from subsuming all our minds into his. So then I found Eretus being attacked by his glow. I helped Tiber resolve things with Orving, as best as he could anyway. I freed Calistige from her personal torment involving his sisters, and I rescued Matkina from reliving all the betrayals against her. Now what's interesting is you would think either we would run across all our companions, past and present, or just the ones that we had at the end. But Matkina is somebody we only brought in the party for a short amount of time, just to, you know, talk to her and see what dialogue she had and what she had to say about the others and vice versa. And yet we found her. But what about Rin, the little girl? What about Allegern? I could see now coming across Rin. She got so upset when we booted her from the crowd because I didn't want to go without any of these guys. So, definitely not. And I felt so bad. They actually had a, you know, an audio of her, yeah, the voice acting of her crying as she ran away. I felt like crying. But yeah, but I could see how we wouldn't come across her, because she would not be summoned by the Bronze Sphere. She would not... We couldn't find her. We couldn't contact her in any way. But Allegern we could. So where the hell is Allegern? Unless we're going to find him through there. Which is weird, because we found the others, these three and Matkina, so much earlier. I've started to journey toward the Resonance. The Spectre is down here somewhere. I have to reach the Resonance before he does. Okay. So let's try to reach the Resonance before he does. We're ready. Well, some of us are kind of hurt. Not that much, though. Hello? Oh, I tried to go map, but we're in... Oh. Okay. Broken Fathom. This goes to the deepest fathom. That's the stasis chamber. Okay, we can press things. Oh, what are we doing here? This is this. We can press this. The dominating image on this panel is a map of the room. Five platforms in a circle around the central platform. It looks like controls to raise the floors, connecting the various platforms. Deep cracks radiate out from three different places, as though someone had smashed the panel in a hurried rage. The controls are unresponsive. And yet you feel something. The floors are like those in a deep fathom where you first awoke after your fatal fall. The platforms, as well as this control panel, are mental constructs like everything else here. They should respond to your will, if you just exert it. Okay, without using tidal surge to draw the sorrow here, let's try to focus our will on the floors of this fathom. Command them to rise. Rise, damn you! Okay, I guess we can't do that. You reach out your mind, trying to feel the tides flowing through this place. You can certainly feel their energy, but the floor remains stubbornly inert. Apparently, it won't be that easy. Focus your will on the control panel to activate it. Got no choice. The tides surround you, swirling throughout the entirety of this place. You exert your will, pushing power through those channels and into the control panel. Even as you watch, the glass reshapes itself, the cracks healing as though they were never there. With a hum and a chitter, the controls come to life. The platform you are standing on pulses with an orange glow, showing the floors in their current state. Touching the platform on the screen should shift the floors. Okay. A familiar voice echoes from the depths below. You're still here, then. I had hoped the labyrinth would trap your mind as well, but apparently I made your body too well. We know who this is. You're too late, though. Even if you repaired the entire fathom, I'm at the labyrinth's final defenses. By the time you reach me, I'll have broken through the door. Go ahead. Solve your puzzles. It won't matter. In a little while, you'll be nothing more than a whiff of nostalgia in my mind. The voice fades to nothing. Well, damn, I hope it didn't take that long. Alright. Can I move again to this? Because I do want to interact with that. Or alternately go here.
On it.
The map on this control panel is fully functional. The platform you are standing on pulses with an orange glow, showing the floors in their current state. Touching the platform on the screen should shift the doors. Or floors, rather. Connect this platform to the one on your right. Oh, crap. It didn't... What? It didn't work the way we wanted it to, didn't it? Tidal energy from the portal blasts the floors back into the depths. You're able to reconnect them to the platform across the fathom, but not to the exit. You'll have to find another way to reach it. Got it. Let's solve our puzzles. Oh, I'm not too late. Oh, but that's not the game telling me that, yeah, you're doomed.
I'm ready.
But have fun with the puzzles. Connect it with the one on the right. With a hum and rattle, pylons rise and fall from the depths, changing the shape of the room. The Spectre's voice booms from below. There's no reason this should be easy for you. You hear a great shout from the depths, and suddenly your mind is buffeted with a powerful blast of tidal force. I'm afraid of attracting the sorrow in here. Let's not resist and see what happens. 4 damage is okay. The blast tears through your mind like a calorail. Your head burns with pain as searing images cross your vision. 4 damage? Is that the best you can do? You stand... Oh, that's cool. We got a memory. You stand in front of a red soulless portal. Your mind aches from the agony of the consumed, tortured minds, but it was worth it. With the gate opened, you will be able to hide from the sorrow. You step beyond and are immediately brought to your knees as some presence crushes your mind. It's not just the souls you have eaten, but something using those souls. It's too much. It will destroy you. You abandon the body in that endless space beyond the gate. You will find another way. The visions fade. You return to the laboratory. Okay, can we connect it here?
I'm going.
The far side of the fathom? Which far side? Something rumbles in the depths beneath you. You feel a blast of wind, then nothing. Did it connect? Or went back over there?
All right.
Alright, let's leave it. We can't. It just alternates.
Something to do.
No, we're just gonna touch Pylon's guy. The map on this control panel is fully functional. The platform you are standing in pulses with an orange glow, showing the floors in their current state. Touching the platform on the screen should shift the floors. There's an extra image here that was not visible on the other panels, a human figure in dotted outline. It flickers erratically, as though something were wrong with it. Press the flickering image of the human figure. As you place your hand on it, something activates within the panel. Not just this panel, but every panel in the room. The circular stations on every platform glow, and the image of the human figure begins to pulse regularly, as though waiting for input. Press it again. Tiny needles puncture your fingers. There's a flash from the circular synth plate next to the panel, and a finger-long blade in its center starts spinning and humming around its axis. As it spins, it projects a three-dimensional image very similar to yourself. Your own body flickers in and out of phase. The blade spins faster, brighter. Your body's flickering accelerates until finally the blade dissolves, and standing on the platform is a fully grown human that looks remarkably like you. What? The figure before you looks almost exactly like you, but a man instead of a woman. He doesn't bear your scars, but otherwise his face is like a mirror. "Hello," he says pleasantly. "You must be me." This isn't the changing god, is it? From another time? He thinks, what happened to her? She did not treat our body all that well. "Who are you?" "Well, I'm a short-lived version of you." He looks you up and down, basically. "Our creator used these cloning stations to rapidly prototype different body types and features before deciding on a final shell for his consciousness." He looks at the control panel. "These look different from the controls I remember. It looks like I'm stuck on the most recent settings." He flashes you a smile. "Not that that's a bad thing, of course. I'm sure you won't mind." "I'm a mock-up of you, before our creator transferred into your body. He would create clones like me as rapid, short-lived prototypes before deciding on the look and feel for his next self." "If you're me, then why are you a man?" "Our progenitor was funny like that. Gender for the next self was always a last-minute decision. Our creator was never content with one, or even two, genders. It was a fungible thing. He would constantly explore and experiment, even trying Vargellan, Gibra, and Dirac bodies at different points." Oh, I want to see a Dirac. He stops, looking more thoughtful. "You know, even after centuries with our creator, I can't explain the fastidiousness about gender. It's just the way he is." He thinks the Vargellan were very interesting. I'm surprised he didn't choose that body more often. "Most likely he set me to male as the prototype, then switched again at the last minute when making you." "If you only live a short time, how do you know all this?" "Oh, that's the most interesting part. Our creator always liked to process things externally, to have someone to talk to. He constructed assistants all the time. I was enabled to maintain my memories from version to version. That way I could provide more useful feedback on how one body moved or felt compared to another. Our progenitor would even have me perform tasks from time to time, sometimes mundane, sometimes dangerous. The fact that I could learn from my mistakes was a great help." "Do you know what this place is?" He looks around. "I thought it was the cloning laboratory where prototype bodies were tested, but this doesn't look right at all. Where's the floor? The walls? All the equipment is here, but..." He looks back to you. "It's like a nightmare version of the laboratory I know. As if someone described the lab to a visitant that didn't quite understand it all, and then that visitant tried to recreate it." He shakes his head. "I don't know." "It's like the cloning laboratory where prototype bodies for the next self were created. The equipment is all here, but everything else is... wrong." "How long do you last?" "Only a few minutes, give or take." Catching your look, he adds, "It's not so bad. It doesn't hurt. At least, I don't remember it hurting." "Could you perform a task for me? Like walk to that other station and toggle the floors?" He gives you a funny look, but says, "Sure, I can do that." Oh my god. It looks like it hurt. He turned into Jibs. It didn't work. What the hell? It didn't work.
Yes.
We still have the human figure. You brace yourself this time. The needles puncture your fingers again, and the blades begin spinning. Your own body flickers in and out of existence. Soon the process is complete, and your clone stands on the platform watching you. Hello again, sister. Can I help help you with something? No. Take care of that body.
Let's go.
Alright, let's connect the platform to the one... Wait. I guess to the right? We really want to go there, but eventually here. Hopefully, yeah, from here we can go there, maybe?
Go.
To the one on your right.
With alacrity.
Okay, so we got this one. Oh, we can press the image here as well. Connect this platform to the one on your right. There is no platform to my right. That's the left. Unless, well, that's the left as well. Yeah, that's the left. I don't know what's going on with you.
On it.
Can he touch the other platform? I need you to toggle the floors at the other station again. He shrugs. Sure, why not? Let's await the Jibs. Ugh. It didn't work. That just connects to that. Oh, there's someone in there. I didn't realize. I thought this was empty. I wonder who that is. The changing god is below, supposedly.
Ready.
Left. Oh. Ah! You're expelled with great force from a black chitinous tube. The earth is far, far below you, but rising fast. Suddenly, a tendril of fire pierces your mind, and everything goes black. The visions fade. Maybe we should have him do it so we don't get hit by 4 damage every time? But how do I get anywhere? How do I get to here or here? This is connected here now. I'm gonna need him to connect it, but every time I...
Sure enough.
I think we're gonna need him to connect it.
Alright.
Alright. Let's see if I can have him toggle it there. Jibs. Ah! We can get across now. Yesh! Not out, but at least we got somewhere.
Of course.
We can interact with whoever the hell this is. Well, that's a woman? It's a stasis chamber, exactly like the one from the ghostly woman's memories. There are no controls on it anywhere. Nothing that could help you raise the floors to reach the depths of the labyrinth. A woman lies inside, clearly visible through the shimmering energy field, and looking as though she were asleep. Her features are exactly those of the ghostly woman. Got it. She's the ghostly woman. Before she became all ghostly, I guess. Something disturbs the air next to you. The ghostly woman's face begins to appear, as though your thoughts summoned her. Oh, wow. You did summon me, she says, intuiting your thoughts. I can discern your memories more clearly than the others, even more clearly than my own. She looks sadly down into the chamber. But I remember now. This is who I was, the daughter of the changing god. Oh, really? He was the father who tried to save me after the siege of the Tabat. Right, the daughter's fathom. That's why it says daughter's fathom. She's the daughter. He discovered how to transfer consciousness, my consciousness, into a new body, hoping it would save me, but it didn't. My sickness followed me, in my mind. So he put me in there. That's right, we figured he was the guy, right? The father who did it. She would live on for 20 years. In different bodies. He tried to find a cure for me, and when that failed, he tried to bring me back from death itself. He thought I was unconscious in there, but I remember. The memories are fragmented, but they're there. I was aware of everything, and with so many new memories flooding my mind, I'm able to fill in the gaps I didn't know. Does this mean you're a cast-off? Her eyebrows scrunch together, then she shakes her head. I don't think so. I had my own consciousness, like my father does. This is who I was. Now I'm probably just a memory, stored forever in the labyrinth. How often has he tried to bring you back? Considering he had centuries to do it? Not very often. A lot at first, then only when he remembered or had some new idea. He used the probability engines underneath Sega's cliffs to birth women with my personality. He tried to use Heaven's Rejoinder, his means for turning back defeats in the endless battle. Once he tried to kidnap a version of me from an alternate reality, but she died in a tragic accident. He never tried that again. She thinks, what am I to you, Father? Did you just give up? Once he tried to kidnap a version of me from an alternate reality, he never considered her death a coincidence, though. How much do you remember from being in that tank? I can't tell you in time measurements. I only know I was in the tank until the sorrow attacked us. My father fled, saving himself. Huh. She laughs once, but there is no humor in it. Maybe he figured he could bring me back even without my body. It's the kind of thing he would assume. Her face darkens. Maybe he didn't care. I don't know how long he kept me in there, but I was there until the sorrow attacked us. My father fled. I, the real me, was destroyed. Does this mean this fathom? Does that mean this fathom is constructed from your memories? She looks around her, taking it all in for the first time. I don't recognize... No, wait. Yes. It's all twisted and disordered, like in a nightmare. But yes, I think these are my memories. I need to get to that portal. Can you build me a path?
My studies have borne fruit.
Awesome. She looks at you directly in the eye, strong and certain. Yes, I can. Awesome. Go, she says. Stop him. He's harmed more lives than anyone can count. If you have the power to heal the floors, would you have the power to heal me as well? Could use it. While you are in this place? Yes, I think I might. You feel nothing more than a tingle as she places her hand on your shoulder. Then an immense weight of tranquility fills your body and mind.
I can breathe again.
Yeah. We can be fully healed again. Sweet. Okay. Let's level Calistees up. Edge. In, intellect.
Our knowledge grows, sisters.
I can hear her now. Successive attack. Applies for melee and ranged attacks. She only attacks with range. It's been forever ago since I had her use anything but a spell. Hedge magic? Or data sphere link? I'll do successive attack. It might come in. Oh, we have both. Alright. Hedge magic then as well. May come in useful, but I doubt it. Anything else to say? Do not dally here. He must be stopped. I'll stop your father. Farewell. Farewell, and thank you.
In this world, then.
In this world. In this fathom, then. So, right. Broken fathom done. Next is deepest fathom. Let me just see if anything has anything new to say. Yeah. There's a lot going on.
Step. They don't want to kick over your memories.
You'd figure they'd have some stuff to say.
Try not to think so hard. I think you're giving me a headache.
Nope. Alright, we're continuing on.
Let's go.
Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.